In the end. Queenie X. The moment we've all been waiting for the past week. In 2022, we get to experience the excitement of a brand new Queen song. For someone that was born like well after Freddie left us, it's one of those things that you wish you could have been able to experience during your lifetime. And I've read and I've heard many experiences from fans who were alive during the 70s, 80s and 90s, and hearing the excitement in their voice when they anticipated a brand new song or brand new album. To say I was envious of them, understatement of the year. Now I must say, before we get into the actual song, which by the way, in my time, it's not even come out yet, but it's been leaked by a French radio station. At this very second, there's still 20 hours before the song's officially released, but we've got our hands on it. Before we get into this, if you're a hardcore Queen fan, then you may or may not be familiar with a leaked demo tape from 1988 or 1989 that had a bunch of demos from the Miracle Sessions, including Face It Alone, in a very incomplete state. And I think it's safe to say, for anyone who's heard it, like me, you probably would have dismissed it as, I don't know, a rough jam that never got any further than that. Obviously not the case. But before we take our very first listen at the completed Face It Alone, I'm gonna play for us a little bit of that demo. So this very rough early demo is not on YouTube anywhere, because earlier this year, a bunch of Queen demos were being taken off of YouTube and struck down. Funnily enough, all of the demos that were taken down were from the Miracle Sessions. I think there were really only lyrics in the first couple minutes, and the rest of it was jams with guitars and drum machines and whatnot. Of course, I cannot remember the last time we've done a reaction. Usually by now I've already done the intro and whatnot, but I've been so excited. So of course, welcome to AUB Figs. I'm Ruben, the host, and if you'd like to see more content like this, smash the like button, smash the subscribe, and watch to the end. It's demo time, and then, for the first time ever, the completed Face It Alone. Let's take a sneak peek at the demo first, though. Okay. Very rough.
Give me that first guitar. After this, you have to give me a guitar entry, yeah?
So rough. This is literally a jam session.
Guitar.
How cool is that to hear Freddie talking in between takes? Yep. So in the days leading up to this release day, this guitar riff has been stuck in my ear non-stop.
Something so dear and so dear.
That's a strong sign that this is very early, because he's singing. He's not even singing words, he's singing the melody so he can put the lyrics in later. Even this rough, the rough vocals, they still sound fantastic. Yeah, that might be the end of the lyrics. It's about 2 minutes in. Okay, we'll stop there. If you're a hardcore Queen fan, this is probably all you would have thought existed of the song, was a rough jam. I certainly thought that. So to hear these sneak peeks that Queen have been posting to their socials the last few days, fresh snippets of parts of the song we've never heard before, very polished, even cleaner vocals. Are you ready? Are we all ready for the premiere? Over like 33 or 34 years after the fact for the first time ever. In its entirety, Queen, Face It, Alone. I don't know what kind of quality this is going to be, because this came from a French radio station. There's only one way to find out.
Et en fait, il avait dit au groupe, je veux pas qu'on en parle, je veux qu'on fasse des chansons sans qu'on s'apitoie sur mon sort. J'y ferai face tout seul. Et donc, c'est une chanson qui est lourde de sens. Face It Alone. C'est l'inédit de Queen dans le Music News d'aujourd'hui.
On est au bon endroit au bon moment.
When something so near and dear to life explodes inside, you feel your soul is set on fire. When something so deep and so far and wide falls down, your cries can be heard so loud and clear. Your life is your own. You're in charge of yourself, master of your own. In the end, you have to face it. To your life explodes inside, you feel your soul is burned alive, burned alive. When something so deep and so far and wide falls down beside you, cry.
Oh, that's what I was gonna say. What the hell was that part then? Roughly a 4-minute song. I don't know if that was a radio edit or if that's the entire thing. Chills. Chills. Those vocals. Immediately. I'd say even from that first sentence, you can tell how much more polished, how much further they worked on the song than what was evident on that demo version. Oh man. And I was also thinking when we got past the first two verses and we got into that, you call it a bridge section or a middle eight section, how eerie that song sounded. I think, obviously, The Miracle came before the Innuendo album. I think this would have been a very good fit on the Innuendo album. which was obviously the last in Freddie's lifetime. But I had read that after the Miracle sessions, after the Miracle album came out and this song didn't make it on it, that they'd worked on it further during the innuendo sessions, which I've got to believe is true now after hearing that. And the same was, if you're familiar with the Queen song All God's People that was on innuendo, that was started in the Miracle sessions too. It was a very similar situation to this. That song wasn't finished, but they got back to it for the next album and they got to a point with it where they were pleased to include it. This one, it sounds like they got so close, at least in my opinion, they got so close to being to a point where they were happy to include it, but for whatever reason didn't go ahead with it. Maybe it was between this and All God's People and they chose that one instead. Who knows? If the band didn't care about the song at all, they would have just thrown it in as a B-side for one of the Miracle singles. And there were loads of B-sides that came out from that period. Hang On In There, Stealing, My Life Has Been Saved, Chinese Torture. They were saving this one. They had plans for this song. And my goodness, Freddie's vocals. You could tell they wanted this song to go somewhere. Whereas I can't see why they would have put this much effort into it. Like the guitar's so polished. The bass even, so eerie. John, that's classic John Deacon. Yeah, those first few chords on the guitar. Just has the hair on the back of my neck standing up. Who knows, in today's day and age, with all the modern artists and how much the charts have changed, who knows? But wouldn't this be amazing if this song, released as a single, how amazing would it be if this song could chart in the top whatever, top 40? If you're watching this video, chances are you are a massive Queen fan too. So how about it? By the time you're watching this, it probably is. First stutter of the video. Nearly got there. By the time you're watching this, it probably is already out officially. What do you say? Let's all stream it on all streaming platforms. Let's do everything in our power to get this into the charts. Spine tingling. I don't know how to describe it. The feeling of hearing Freddie Mercury's fresh vocals on a brand new song in 2022. Surreal, really is. And it's obvious they got so close to including this on something. But as I said, they could have chucked this in as a B-side on one of the Miracle singles. They could have even chucked it on one of the innuendo singles as a B-side if they wanted to. But this song meant more to them than that. And in 2022, we finally all get to enjoy it together. What are your thoughts? Have you come to this video from just listening it to the first time on Spotify? Or is this video right here the first time you've heard the song at all? Let me know down in the comments, and what do you think of this song? Anyway, that's enough from your boy for today. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please let me know by smashing the like button, leaving a comment, subscribe.